은혜 받으실 말씀은
Today's reading scripture is Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, and Revelation 22, 20 to 21. Genesis 1, 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Revelation 22, 20 to 21. He who testifies to these things says, Yes, I am coming quickly. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with all. Amen. After Golden Light Choir's praise, Miryang Manmin Church's pastor, Pastor Moon-taekyu, will preach under the title Flow of Spirit. It's the third session. Thank you, Golden Light Choir's praise. Congregations, it is the third session on Flow of Spirit. During the previous sessions, I talked about the era of God the Father and the era of God the Son and for fathers of faith in the eras. 2 Timothy 3:16 says, All scripture is profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correcting, for training in righteousness. We'd like to share God's grace. Introducing Jesus' disciples. As Jesus started his ministry, his words and deeds were spread. The people were interested in him and gathered around him because they hadn't seen things that Jesus did and heard words that he spoke from their leaders, then there was a separation among them. There were Jesus' followers and rejectors. About that time, Jesus called his 12 disciples. They were always with Jesus. They were in the center of his ministry and they communicated with them. Their names are Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew, his brother, and James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew, the tax collector, James, the son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas Iscariot. Their occupations varied. Peter, Andrew, James, and John were fishermen. Matthew was a tax collector. Simon, the Canaanite, was the Zealot. The Zealot rebelled against the Roman Empire with the purpose of building a sacred nation that God rules over. Thus, we can guess that there was a conflict with tax collectors who were hired by Roman Empire. Matthew 9:11 says, Pharisees didn't like Jesus eating in the house of Matthew, the tax collector. They said, Why is your teacher eating with the tax collectors and sinners? Simon, the Canaanite, and Matthew, the tax collector, had conflicting positions. This tells Jesus didn't consider their occupations or appearance when he selected his disciples. He called them according to their heart. Other disciples' occupations were not recorded in the Bible, but we can infer theirs. Philip was the Bethsaida, were not recorded, but we can of the city of Andrew and Peter, fishermen. Thomas went back to fish at the Sea of Tiberias with Peter and some other disciples after Jesus died. From it, we can infer their occupation. Judas Iscariot was a smart man. As soon as he saw Mary pour a perfume on Jesus, he calculated its value, 300 denarii. His calculating ability helps us infer his occupation. Therefore, there was Matthew who managed tax business among them, but Judas became the treasurer. The disciples' characters varied too. They gradually changed by Jesus' teachings. They saw Jesus' resurrection and ascension, and they received the Holy Spirit. After that, they devoted their life to the kingdom of God. Tonight, I talk about how several disciples who lived in the time of God, the Son, rode the flow to learn how we ride on the flow of Spirit. We can learn many things from them. Maybe may you be filled with self-discovery, realization, God's grace and thanks. I pray in the name of the Lord. First, James and John, they are brothers. Jesus added the name Son of Thunder because of their character. Luke 9 well describes their characters. One day Jesus and his disciples were on the way to Jerusalem. They tried to find a place to stay in Samaria, but were rejected. So James and John said, Lord, do you want us to command fire to come down from heaven and consume them? Jesus rebuked them. He didn't accept their fleshly thoughts caused by their feelings. In Matthew 20, their mother, Salome, came to Jesus with them. She said, command that in your kingdom these two sons of mine may sit one on your right and one on your left. And I thought they had their mother's characters. Their mom wanted them to be ahead. So I thought they had their mom's characters. Jesus didn't miss the chance, but advised them in a spiritual way. Jesus talked about the kingdom of God to his disciples and the people around him in a timely manner. He said, are you able to drink the cup that I am about to drink? And they said, we are able. And Jesus said to them, my cup you shall drink, but to sit on my right and on my left, this is not mine to give, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared by my Father. He meant even though they were able to drink the cup that he was about to drink, it is the authority of God who would sit on the Lord's left and right side. Then what is the meaning of the cup that Jesus said? It is a cup that makes up the love of the cross. Jesus fulfilled the love of the cross and sat on the right side of God's throne. As Philip 2:5-8 says, Jesus existed in the form of God, but humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death. How did the other disciples feel listening to the conversation between them? Verse 24 says, hearing this, the ten became indignant with the two brothers. Rather than trying to find out what the meaning of the cup, the ten were feeling jealous of the two brothers. They also had a self-righteousness and frameworks for the teacher. Seeing them, Jesus didn't let it go but called them. And he said, the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them and exercise authority over them. But it is not this way among you. Whoever wishes to become great among you shall be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you shall be your slave. To become great, you should be a servant. To become first, you should be a slave. And he said in verse 28, just as the Son of Man didn't come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. If they had understood the spiritual meaning and being changed, they could help him more. They realized the meaning after they saw his crucifixion, resurrection, and ascension, and received the Holy Spirit. As you know well, Jesus taught them restlessly. Jesus believed that they couldn't realize it, but could do when they received the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit would bring to their remembrance all that he said to them. James and John's characters were like thunder, but they gradually were changed. As they were changed, they could be with the Lord on the Mount of Transfiguration. They were as intimate as they accompanied the Lord when he went to Gethsemane to pray. They could sacrifice their own life for the Lord. So, James was the first martyr, and John was called Apostle of Love, and kept his faith firmly even before the boiling oil pot was exiled to Patmos. He wrote the book of John, and 1st, 2nd, 3rd John, and Revelation. He was an exceptional man after God's own heart. We long for spiritual advice. But how about now? I believe you who are advised by men or in the works of the Holy Spirit are being renewed every day. If you are criticized, you should give thanks. Second, Matthew. Matthew was a tax collector. Tax collectors were rejected by Pharisees and scribes because they served the Roman Empire that ruled over Israel. In Matthew chapter 9, Jesus called Matthew sitting in the tax collector's booth as his disciple. Jesus ate at his home. Pharisees felt unpleasant and said, "Why is your teacher eating with the tax collectors and sinners?" Jesus heard this and said, "It is not those who are healthy who need a physician, but those who are sick." But go and learn what this means. I desire compassion and not sacrifice, for I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners. Jesus, the Son of God, told them about why he came to the earth. He didn't come to the earth for the people who are healthy, but the people who are sick. He wanted mercy and love rather than sacrifice. He said about Jews, ceremonial sacrifice without their heart. That's why he mentioned about sacrifice. They were bounded within the elders of the traditions of elders. Isaiah 1:12 says, "When you come to appear before me, who requires of you this trampling of my court?" He didn't please the habitual sacrifice with our heart, with our offering heart. There were unrighteousness and lawlessness behind the habitual sacrifice. Hosea 6:6 says, "For I delight in loyalty rather than sacrifice, and in the knowledge of God rather than burnt offerings." We should offer sacrifices with loyalty and with seeking God's heart. The purpose of sacrifice is to worship God. We offer thanks, praise, and glory to Him, and also offer our desire, our wishes. In John 4:24, Jesus said, "God is spirit, and those who worship Him must worship in spirit and truth." So we should look back on our attitude when we attend worship service. We should worship God in spirit and truth. And please check, do you remember the message after finishing the service? I hope you accept messages in your heart and keep it in your mind. How did Matthew feel listening to what Jesus said? He must have had a lot of worries because of his occupation. He was rejected, but Jesus knew him and advocated him. How touched it must have been. Matthew helped Jesus in his ministry and wrote his ministry in detail. It is the first book of the New Testament, the book of Matthew. The third is Thomas. People call Thomas a doubting disciple. It was made when the resurrected Jesus appeared among his disciples. They saw Jesus who had been resurrected and said to Thomas, Thomas said, "Unless I see in his hands the imprint of the nails and put my finger into the place of the nails and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." He didn't believe his teacher's resurrection and his colleague's testimony. We can see him in the Bible. John 11 reads about how Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. Jesus heard Lazarus had been sick, but he didn't go to him right after hearing it, but visited him 4 days later. His disciples urged him not to go because he had been about to be stoned. At that time, Thomas said to his colleagues, "Let us also go so that we may die with them." It could be interpreted like, "Let's follow Jesus with our determination of death," but it was irrelevant. Before Thomas said so, Jesus said to them, "If anyone walks in the day, he does not stumble, and Lazarus didn't die, he isn't dead." But they didn't understand what Jesus meant. They should have said, "Let's go with them to see God's glory." Thomas should have said, "Let's go with them to see God's glory." Another story is written in John 14. Jesus said to his disciples, "If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. That where I am, there you may be also." Thomas said, "Lord, do you not know where you are going? How do we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me." Thomas didn't try to get an answer when he didn't understand Jesus' words, but directly said what he thought.
궁구하기보다는 본인의 생각을 직설적으로 표현하는 사람임을 볼 수 있습니다.
So, he couldn't believe his fellow disciples' testimony, but said that he could believe only when he saw him with his own eyes. Jesus said to Thomas in John 20:27, Reach here with your finger and see my hands, and reach here your hand and put it into my side. Do not be unbelieving, but believing. Thomas said, My Lord and my God, he preached the gospel according to the Lord's command, preached the gospel to the end of the earth. And he was murdered in India. Fourth, I talk about Judas Iscariot. He was one of the disciples of Jesus, but I felt pain when I think about him. When he was selected as a disciple, he might have a dream. He saw signs, wonders, and God's power, and he was touched when he saw many people following Jesus. Judas Iscariot was different from the 11. He was a calculating person. He calculated the price of the perfume quickly, and he sold his teacher because he wasn't beneficial anymore. Jesus gave him advice of love to make him change and be saved. And he hid, Judas Iscariot hid the heart of thief. But Jesus said, remember the Mary's deed. And if Judas Iscariot thought about the Jesus words, he could think he had a wrong heart, he had an untruthful heart. And also, Jesus said, one of you will betray me, and he who dipped his hand with me in the bowl is the one who will betray me. Jesus said this to his disciples. But Judas Iscariot missed this chance again. I think about how much it would have been good if he had gained some realizations from Jesus' words. But he couldn't realize because of greed. He felt nothing even though Jesus said something to him. And he lost all the fear and respect. He changed his mind. He changed his first love, so he sold his teacher, receiving 30 silver coins, and he finished his life by killing himself. And Matthew 26:24 says, The Son of Man is to go just as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been good for that man if he hadn't been born. Senior pastor desires for the people like Judas Iscariot to repent and be saved. That's why he wants to complete the 100% of the power of recreation.
공의를 채우는 시간들을 보내고 계시는 것입니다. 우리가 또한 감사할 것은 우리의 영적인 감각이 떨어지지 않았다는 것에 대해서 이 가룟 유다를 보면서 감사해야 합니다.
So we have to be thankful because we have a spiritual eyes to learn from the Bible, learn from the forefathers of faith. And we must be thankful because we do not lose the way toward New Jerusalem. You are still walking the way. Lastly, I will talk about Pilate. Pilate is not a disciple of Jesus, but I want to talk about him because we learn something from him. There are some who made me feel pity in the Bible. One of them is Pilate. He is one of the people who participated in God's providence, but I feel pity on him very deeply. But he wasn't used as an instrument of evil by force to fulfill God's providence without his free will. I mean, he utilized his untruthful fleshly thoughts with his free will and accepted the works of Satan. God loves everyone and wants them to be saved. He wants even sinners to grasp a chance of salvation. As righteous deeds reward the righteous doers, evil deeds return to the evildoers. Pilate knew that Jesus was caught by Jews' jealousy and that Jesus didn't do wrong. So Pilate tried to save his life. He wanted to use the custom at the feast to release a prisoner. Pilate picked a notorious sinner who was contrasted with Jesus. His name was Barabbas. He was obviously a contrast. Pilate asked the crying crowd, "Whom do you want me to release for you, Barabbas or Jesus who is called Christ?" And Pilate wanted the hope that they picked Jesus. But they, incited by the high priest and elders, cried, "Barabbas, crucify Jesus." Pilate questioned them again, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they didn't listen to him, but kept saying, "Crucify him." Pilate came up with a way out. It was to wash his hands and say, "I am innocent of this man's blood. See to what did to the yourselves." And it is not, he wants to say, "It is not what I want to do. I do this because you want me to do this." And he handed over to be crucified. He handed Jesus over to be crucified. So how good would it be if Pilate's sins were eliminated? He was advised to have nothing to do with Jesus, but didn't pay attention to it. He was afraid of civil riots and of losing his vested interests. Because of them, he made a wrong decision, and he is enduring the pain in hell. So we shouldn't be afraid of death when we do the right thing. I feel heavy in my heart. Let me catch my breath. Peter is the best disciple of Jesus. Luke 5 reads about how Jesus called Peter as his disciple. Jesus got into the boat and said to Peter, "Put out into the deep water and let down your nets for a catch." Peter answered, "Master, we worked hard all night and caught nothing. What I will do is you say and let down the nets." Consequently, he enclosed a great quantity of fish. After that, Jesus said to him, "You will be catching men." And he left everything and followed Jesus. Peter loved Jesus more than anyone. He was more rebuked by Jesus than the other 11. Peter said to Jesus, walking on the water, "Command me to come to you on the water." Nobody could think to try it. As Jesus said, come. He walked on the water. But seeing the wind, he became frightened and beginning to sink. Jesus said to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" Which is spiritual advice, because he actively tried to do something. When Jesus said that he would go to Jerusalem, suffer many things, be killed, and be raised up on the third day, Peter took him aside and said, "God forbid it. This shall never happen to you." Peter said this for Jesus. But Jesus said to him, "Get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me, for you are not setting your mind on God's interests, but man's." Jesus rebuked Peter without reading his face. It could be possible because he loved Jesus and could do anything if it was for his teacher. The people who long for spirit don't know, they are not afraid of being rebuked. They think rebukes help them grow faith. Matthew 26:31, Jesus said to his disciples during eating, "You shall all fall away because of me this night. For it is written, I will strike down the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock shall be scattered." Peter replied, "Even though all may fall away because of you, I will never fall away." This shows Peter's love for Jesus. Then he heard a great thing that would grow his faith. Jesus said, "Truly I say to you that this very night, before a rooster crows, you will deny me three times." But Peter said with confidence, "Even if I have to die with you, I will not deny you." As Jesus said, Peter denied him three times. And Peter realized his inner person, it was God's grace. And he engraved the Lord's grace in his heart. And he became a person of faith who wasn't afraid of death. He became the apostle of power and was martyred after he finished his duty, and he died on the cross upside down, feeling the love of the Lord. Peter wanted to understand, wanted to learn the truth, and asked Jesus, "Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Up to seven times?" Jesus said to him, "Up to 70 times seven." It is about forgiveness. He meant to forgive completely, regardless of the number. It doesn't mean to forgive without repentance. If someone doesn't repent but is forgiven, it can be stained by evil more. So disciplinary actions are necessary sometimes, but love must be premised. Jesus explained in detail. There was a person who owed his king 10,000 talents. The king felt compassion and forgave him the debt. But the person found one of his fellow who owed him 100 denarii. He seized him and choked him and put him in prison. Then, summoning the king, he said to him, "You wicked slave, and handed him over to the torturers.
붙이는 내용으로 소개해 주었습니다. 그러시면서
And Jesus said, My heavenly Father will also do the same to you. If each of you does not forgive his brother from your heart,
너희들은 어떤 사람이 되겠느냐며 깨우침을 주신 것입니다.
Peter gave Jesus a question, and with the question, Jesus gave them a lesson about forgiveness. Do we forgive? Our sins are forgiven, and we are saved from death. It is possible, it could be possible because of God's grace and the Lord's grace. So we are now changing, we are growing our faith. One day, my church member said to me, Person A, I don't mention his name, that person said, he had repented, but I couldn't feel God's grace from him. So I thought the church member might have a lot of things on his mind. He knew the truth, and I thought about how I could help him. When a movie was taken in the past, films were used, and editors cut some unnecessary scenes and then put the films together to make a whole movie. People can sin because they fail to overcome their fleshly attribute. But when the sinners repent, God forgives them. God forgives and doesn't remember. Isaiah 43:25 says, I am the one who wipes out your transgressions for my own sake. I will not remember your sins. It means that God cuts the unnecessary sin, and He will not remember our sins when we completely repent. And the Bible says, as far as the east is from the west, so far has He removed our transgressions from us. Isaiah 1:18 says, Come now and let us reason together, says the Lord, though your sins are as scarlet, they'll be as white as snow, though they are red like crimson, they'll be like wool. Luke 15:7, I tell you that in the same way there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. And we can learn how we forgive someone from the verses. So, we must remember our God is pleased with the person who repents with hearts. Matthew 6:14-15 says, For if you forgive others for their transgressions, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, then your Father will not forgive your transgressions. God forgives and He doesn't remember. But if man doesn't forgive or keep remembering, he is higher than God. But man cannot be higher than man. Man is a doer of the law, not a judge of it. God gives life. John 6:63 says, It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and are life. And do you remember the fruit of the Holy Spirit? One of them is mercy. We have to have mercy. We have to bear the fruit of mercy. But it's not easy to have the heart of mercy. But when we have mercy, we can understand everyone. But the fruit of mercy, we can accept sinners, we can forgive others.
어떤 경우에 정말 용서하고 싶은데 용서가 안 되는 분야가 있으신지요? 한번 통 크게
Please have mercy in your heart and accept every fellows, every people, then you can feel your heart become large. Through this trials, you can change, you can become a man of spirit. We can do this, but God can do it. Do this and by the help of God, by the love of God, by the help of the Holy Spirit, we can do this. God wants us to become a man of spirit, so we have to try, we have to make efforts. Think about God's love. He gave His only begotten Son to us, for us, as a sacrifice. So we have to feel God's longing for us. Then we can lead our Christian life happily, joyfully. Let me conclude this message. I talk about James, John, Matthew, Thomas, Peter among Jesus' disciples and learn from them. And we also got a lesson from Judas Iscariot and Pilate. Human cultivation takes place not so differently. It takes place even today when we are living, which we will choose between the flow of spirit and the flow of flesh depends on us. The signs of the end time in Matthew 24 appear today. There are secrets to overcome the world in Manmin. We can see many things that shows it is the end time. But we do not be wiped by the worldly flow. But keep riding on the flow of spirit. We can get the answer when you think about what we have experienced in Manmin. Congregations, I hope you cheer up a little more and lead an awakened Christian life. May you ride on the flow of spirit in the Holy Spirit with God's grace and look at the glory of God in the name of the Lord, I pray. Let's pray thinking over the message.